So we have just talked about brainstorming. That's it. But there's a lot to talk about, right? So, たかがブレインストーミング、されどブレインストーミングですよ。Yes. なんか日本語好きの外人みたいになってきた。So, this is the same exercise, put it in Japanese. So, you know, for those who are more comfortable in Japanese. So, you need to think, you know, after done several minutes or so, this is good exercise, good habit. あれ、違うわ。日本語だ。こう、ちょっとブレインストーミングした後に、これ、上手に発散してるかなって一回考えてみるといいです。で、上手にっていうのは、ただ単純になんか同じ種類がいっぱい出てきてるんじゃなくて、例えば野菜の種類がバーって出てきてるんじゃなくて、まあ、ある意味でいろんな方角に広がってるかなと。さっきちょっとこのチームでも言ってたんですけど、できればこう360度思考が広がっていくといいですよね。で、ちょっと覚えておくといいのは、まあ、時間、空間、意味方向、3つぐらいは簡単に発散できると思っておいてください。あるものに対して、あるアイディアに対して、例えばそこから次のアイディアに行ってみるときに、自由連想してみるときに時間、空間、意味の方向に発散する。例えば、リンゴって言われて、時間の方向に発散したら、かじられたリンゴなんていうこともできるかなとかですね。意味の方向だったら、なんか美味しいリンゴとか、まずいリンゴとか、なんかそんな風に言っていくこともできるだろうし、昨日食べたリンゴとかも言えるかもしれないし、とか、こういうですね、いくつかこう発散していくっていう、この思考の発散っていうののやり方みたいなのも少し心得ておくと、この、まあ、ブレインストーミングというのも上手になりますよということですし、あと、どのような設問であれば多様性を生かしてより効果的な発散ができそうかななんてこともですね、ぜひ、これ本当にブレインストーミングで、やはり自分たちが考えてもなかったこととかでですね、たどり着こうと思ったら、こういうことを少し意識してもらうといいですねと。で、なぜブレインストーミングの設問にこんだけとやかく言うかというと、やっぱりこう意図的に思考の発散をですね、行う工夫をしようということを思っていただきたいということですね。これ、ほっといたら皆さんの頭は、整理する方向に動きますからね。ほっといたら絶対そっちに動きます。人間はそういうふうにできてるんです。なので、できるだけ意図的に発散する方向に自分の頭って向けないとそうはならないんだなってことをよくよく噛みしめてください。これ誰とやっても一緒です。はいですね。で、まあ、これはちょっと後にしましょう。 So okay, you have done brainstorming. OkayBrainstorming is really common, but there's a lot to talk about. And it has a lot of essence to this. So even though we talked about only brainstorming, but it's, I think, all the discussion we had is general for divergent thinking. When you need to diverge your idea or thinking, then everything we talked for brainstorming applies. Okay? So please, please, be careful about that. And so, okay.Now we're going to move into one of the convergent thinking methodology, affinity diagram. So affinity diagram activity, you make groups from your post-it notes and give them unique names. And what you gain is a bird's eye view of your ideas. So you see trends and biases. And then another way to put it is you get higher abstraction level information of your ideas or post-it notes. Understand? Okay. AndAffinity diagram as a discussion process within a group, okay? This is the perspective that I would like to talk about just a little bit. So you will be discussing not about the individual ideas, but one notch higher in abstraction level. So take a look at the post-it note you have in front of you, okay? You can discuss each post-it note, right? You can discuss each note. Instead, I will ask you to group them and discuss, okay?And what essentially it's doing is you are going in a higher abstraction level. Abstraction. 抽象度が1個高いところで議論しましょうということですね。いくつかのポストイットを集めてグループにして、ちょっと抽象度の高いところの議論をしようということですね。You will be accommodating the interpretation of ideas in group. これはどのグループが、まあ、どのポストイットがどういうふうな意味かとかですね、どのグループに属するかみたいな、そういうこう、なんていうんですかね、解釈っていうんですかね、解釈を皆さんでアコモデートって、これ合意の形成ですね、合意形成しながら進めてますねということですね。And again, you want to stay in innovative thinking mode. So you need to strategically choose what type of grouping you want. Okay? There are mainly two types of grouping. logical and critical thinking grouping. So basically, you're following the taxonomy, right? You are following the dictionary definition and see what is close and what are groups, okay? Instead, you can be creative thinking grouping, okay? And you are looking for insights, in other words, hints or clues, to think outside of the box, okay? That's what you're essentially doing. Here's an example, okay? Okay, do you remember my examples of brainstorming? Okay, this was the face-to-face communication without a common language. So I can group them like this, hand gestures, and then facial expression. They group them and I say, currently it's somewhat universally understood group, okay? And then I can say, I take my drawing pictures and dance moves and say, highly dependent on one's skill set, right? Because if you're like a bad dancer, then no one would understand what you're saying. Like, what? Octopus? Right? That can happen. And body gestures and leg, feet gestures and drawing diagrams should probably conform some kind of rules or framework. Otherwise, it cannot communicate to somebody, probably. And then mimicking animals and mimicking insects. Savannah hunters may actually do this kind of things. Right? Like, you know, special kind of hunters may have certain communication tools. So this is more creative type grouping, right? Instead of just making it a logical, critical thinking grouping. So discuss and find interesting perspective to group. Because this way you can find some insight. Because isn't this interesting? Yeah? This is something to dig in, right? Hey, maybe we should search a little bit about hunters, different hunters around the world. They may have crazy communication ways. Hey, maybe that's a good idea. So you want to find something like that. You want to find something like that. It's not about just logically grouping. If logical grouping is required or necessary, do it. That's fine. But you need to choose. You need to be strategically choosing logical and critical thinking, grouping and creative thinking, okay? All right, and for those who are more familiar with Japanese, and in Japanese, there's something very different thing will happen because, do you remember my Japanese examples? So, fukafuka to attakai をグループにして、やっぱりどうしても触りたかったグループにしようと。なんかその時にこういう声が出てそうかなみたいな。とか、意外とそうでもないとか、を生きてるとか結構ザラザラじゃんみたいなのは、でこう考えてたのとは違ってちょっとびっくりしてこういうこと言ってるグループだねとか言ってでわ冷たいとかかなり硬いなみたいなコメントはこう予想通りの時にこういう感じのこと言ってるかもなとかですねでなんか変な感じだねとか不思議だなっていうもしコメントがあったとしたらこれそもそも触ってよかったのかグループってことにしとこうみたいな例えばまあこんな風に実はとかやっぱりとかちょっとですねあのこのポストイットが共有するエッセンスをですね、こう創造的に見つけ出そうっていう努力をしてみると、ああ、そうか、人間って例えばそういう時にそういうこと言っちゃうのかもしれないね、みたいなディスカッションをトリガーしたりすることができますよということです。単純にグルーピングするのも悪くないんですけど、そこから何か得られるかどうかっていうのがミソです。グループを作りたいわけでは決してないですからね。それは小学生でもできますから。そうではなくて、このグルーピングすることで、あ、そうかってことを見つけたいわけですからね。はい。So here's an example of logical versus creative grouping. This is more logical and critical thinking type grouping. So hand gestures, facial expression, leg, feet, body, dance moves. Use human body parts to communicate, right? Drawing pictures, drawing diagrams. Create visual aid to communicate, right? And then mimicking insect, mimicking animal. Mimic other life form that communicates. More logical grouping. Instead, I did creative type grouping, just as I showed you. All right. So I'm not saying choose either one, but there are differences. Okay. I want you to realize that there are differences. Okay. Sometimes you need logical thinking grouping. Sometimes you want creative thinking grouping. Okay. And it's a good habit to do multiple times. Do affinity diagram for multiple times. Because you may find something new, all right? And here's a Japanese example. 好きな食べ物から新技を作成しましょうと。いいですか？これ、好きな食べ物、ブレインストーミングしました。はい。 肉系、野菜系、麺系、おやつ系、飲み物系です。どうですか、なんかこうインサイトありますか、ここから。麺一種類かみたいな。ちょっと苦しいですよね、ちょっと苦しいですよね。でも例えばなんか粉物好きな人がいないってことは、これ関西の人いないんじゃないみたいな、なんかもうインサイトっていうよりもこじつけです、これ。はい、こじつけ、はい。じゃあ例えばこれどうですか、これどういう神話図だと思います。シーズン、あ、こうなんか夏っぽい感じ。ああ、なるほど。これですね、まあこれ極端な例なんですけど、これ食べられそうな場所です。スズメって食べられますよ、行くとこ行けば。地元の居酒屋さんで食べられそうだなみたいなのと、なんか近所のカフェで食べられそうだねとか、おばあちゃんの家で食べられそうだねみたいな、これちょっと視点を変えるだけで全然違うグルーピングができますねと。でこれを例えば、まあ、好きな食べ物で神話図を作ってたとして、で皆さんがなんかそうですね、レストランのフランチャイズをもし考えてるようなベンチャーだったとしたら、なんかこうおしゃれなレストランに行くより結構こう身近なスポットで好きなものを食べるタイプっていうのがこのチームには多いのかもしんないねみたいなことを言えるわけですね、例えば。でだったら、あ、そしたらさと、今ここに出てなくて身近に感じる食事をする場所って他にどこがあるか、ちょっとブレインストーミングもうちょっとやってみようかと。土手とか、土手いいね、公園いいね、公園いいね、公園っぽいレストランいいねみたいなのが、例えばですよっていう話がこうしていけるわけですよね。それがですね、これだとちょっと麺どうするみたいな、なんかちょっと難しいですよね。なので悪いと言ってるわけじゃないんですけど、自分たちが何の目的でどういうふうにこのグルーピングしてるかなというのをですね、よく考える必要がありますよということです。何回かやってみると良いでしょう。でこれですね、日本の方覚えておくといいですよ。神話図であって類似図じゃないと覚えておいた方がいいです。類似図だったら似たのを集めればいいんです。そうじゃなくて神話図なんで、親と子は類似じゃないですよね、神話ですよね。例えばカエルとオタマジャクシは類似じゃなくて神話ですよね。なのでこう似たもの同士というんじゃなくて、神話性のあるもの同士を集めてるんだなと。で神話性の定義っていうのはいろいろあるよなと覚えておくといいです。のでそれをですね、アフィニティって、まあ英語そのままですけどね、はい。 OK So it's a time to exercise. So discuss and create affinity diagram from the brainstorming result. Okay, try to createAffinity diagram multiple times, okay, with different perspective and affinity definition. Okay, take a picture once you create one and then destroy it and do it again. All right, and so when you are making groups and giving them names, try to find insight that may lead the design process to innovative outcome. That's the intention that you want, you have in your mind.Do you now see something you did not see when you are brainstorming? Do you see something new? Some any trend, bias, or whatsoever? So organize and structure to interpret ideation result. So that's what you're doing. Okay? So, all right, now take your ideation result and start developing affinity diagram. I'll give you another 20 minutes. So try, do it once.And then take a picture and do it differently the second time, okay? All right? And then discuss what kind of perspective, what could be found, and things like this. All right? You can, of course, start with logical grouping if you want to. That's okay. And then you can break that logical grouping into creative one. That's fine. Or you can try two creative ones. Or you can do two logical ones from different perspective.It's about how you set your perspective, how you discuss your affiliation, all right? Okay, I'll give you 20 minutes. I'll look around. If you have any questions, feel free to stop me. All right, go ahead.
いや、多分順番でやるし、あ、順番でやるし、あ、順番でやるし、あ、順番でやるし、あ、順番でやるし、あ、順番でやるし、あ、順番でやるし、あ、順番でやるし、あ、順番でやるし、あ、順番でやるし、あ、順番でやるし、あ、順番でやるし、あ、順番でやるし、あ、順番でやるし、あ、順番でやるし、あ、順番でやるし、あ、順番でやるし、あ、順番でやるし、あ、順番でやるし、あ、順番でやるし、あ、順番でやるし、あ、順番でやるし、あ、順番でやるし、あ、順番でやるし、あ、順番でやるし、あ、順番でやるし、あ、順番でやるし、あ、順番でやるし、あ、順番でやるし、あ、順番でやるし、あ、順番でやるし、あ、順番でやるし、あ、順番でやるし、あ、順番でやるし、あ、順番でやるし、あ、順番でやるし、あ、順番でやるし、あ、順番で
Sorry, I mislead you just a little bit. Don't think too much, okay? All right, because emergent grouping is important. 総発的グルーピングも大事ですからね。So you do while thinking and you think while doing. So don't think too much.
ここら辺は予想行き気分な感じですか？日常的な。ちょっと晴れの日。
やるぞみたいな。
やるぞみたいな。
気合が必要とか。
あ、なるほど。 一人じゃなくて、人と、まあ、ちょっと微妙な問題だけど、まあ、確かに。
I want you to discuss both process and then the output, okay? Process of making groups. And then find another color post-it notes, okay? Let's call it, that's an inside color, right? That's your inside post-it notes, okay? Write down interesting finding or new question that arose from discussing about the affinity diagram. They may be important insight, okay? If you find anything interesting, if you find anything, any new questions, write it down, okay, write it down. So it's a good habit to keep this insight, you know, on a different post-it note, okay? Don't just let it go, don't just speak and let it go, write it down, okay? And what is interesting about the groups? Any surprise or unexpected thing that happened? Or what was discussed when you changed the group name, if that happened? What happened? Why did you change that name? You know, so don't just focus on the output, but try to remember the process too, because that process might trigger insight. Okay? And any common but essential finding or any indication for further idea exploration, okay, please discuss such things. And then after that, you can try another affinity diagram. All right? I will give you another 15 or 20 minutes to do so. So please do this and have some insight post-it note and then recreate the affinity diagram. So again, this is not just a practice, but it's trying to, I want you to try to get it ready for the actual real project type environment, okay? You will never be given to create affinity diagram. あの新画像を作れっていう指示が誰から来ることは絶対ないですか？ないです。自分でこれってさ言いながら、これをやりながら何か新しい方向性とか自分たちの考えたことの隙間とか何かそういうことを見つけるために自分たちで意識してやらなくちゃいけないので、なので次あれやってこれやってのは誰も教えてくれないので、自分たちでそういうことを見つけていかなきゃいけないんだなって意識を強烈に持ってやっていただければいいかなと思います。 Alright? Go on!
20歳の人に会うことができます。 考えるための糖分が必要な方は前に一つかに持ってください。一つかに1000円です。
どっちかが僕。
People, you are doing good. You're doing good. So I want you to go one notch higher. Okay? Do you remember how to distinguish good insight? Okay, from my definition, good insight is unusual but interesting, right? And unfamiliar but convincing. Okay? Are you looking for that kind? Or are you looking for same old, same old? Meaning, いつも出てくるやつ. Okay? So, for example, so this is my insight that there might be implicit basic framework for universally understood gestures. This is, I don't know, this is still vague, but from this currently it's somewhat
universally understood. Hand gestures and some facial gestures, facial expressions are understood by many people, like okay, and like I don't know, some gestures are. So is there like implicit basic framework behind this? So this is my insight, or this may be my insight. Or new question, should we do more research on primitive communication methods, you know, inspired by this hunting people? Okay, this may be an insight. And Japanese case, for example, so やっぱりどうしても触りたかった by looking at that or 予想通りこう予想をするから人間って触って確かめたくなるのか予想をしない別に気にもしないんだったら触りもしないかなみたいなだからなんか微妙に予想させるような感覚の方が触ってもらいやすくなるかもしれないねとかあと全く予想できないものに関する感覚ってどんなだろうと冷たいのか熱いのか見てるだけじゃ全然わかんないものって人間は果たして触るのかなどうかなみたいなのはちょっと考えてみてもいいかしらとかですねこういうですねちょっとこう手の込んだというかこうインサイトらしきものをですね探そうという努力をちょっとあと10分ぐらいしてみてくださいいいですか So I want you to go up one notch higher because you want to create innovative solution right at the very end so you want to find interesting and innovativeinsight right so that it will drive you to interesting direction or innovative direction so I don't want to see 昨日の日経に載ってるタイプ insight okay like 家族の絆大事 no I read that in 日経 all right so I don't want that I want you to find interesting unique insight got it all right I'll give you another 10 minutes to do so all right go on
ある意味健康的な疲れて帰ったら、私は大好き。
象が発生しないと、
I'm going to go to the next one.
Important insights found? Or maybe not quite insight, but interesting finding? Can you share us? Okay, please. Share, yes.
So our brainstorming timer is the thing we cannot share to other people because we hesitate to talk.
Okay.
So for example,
you're kind of shy about it.
Yeah,
or
shy about it, or
you want to hide about it.
Hide about it.
Okay.
Like our six something problem, or
okay.
Sometimes we have some bad teeth or.
Bad breath, maybe?
Breath stinks or
okay.
Something like that. So we gathered some such ideas and we discussed about that.
Mm-hmm.
And we found some interesting situation. One member said he has a problem about he's too tall. And one member said the opposite thing, she's too short. So there is these kind of things we do not have a proper answer. Even in I'm in the middle. I think my height is average Japanese male, but I want to be more higher, taller. So there is no answer. That is one interesting finding.
Mm.
And the other one is we have some problem about some doing too much or something.
Mm.
So if we do, if we want to make us more thinner, but we, yesterday night I ate too much.
Mm.
So that is why we do that.
Mm.
Why we do that is because there is an ideal of myself, but we are now we are here.
Mm.
So if we want to my ideal side, I have to, I have to avoid our big dinner.
Mm.
But sometimes we smoke, we drink, and sometimes we are buying too much things like that. So we are substitute something to this kind of ideal myself.
Mm.
So. Any other comment?
Okay, so I think we need more discussion about
mm-hmm.
it. But I think we can get a good outcome
mm.
because the yes, as he said, in this is alternative activities mm-hmm. to overcome the gap mm-hmm. between current state
okay.
and idea. And I researched in the Google. Mm-hmm. It is related to Adler psychology. Mm. So through this discussion, we can find the next discussion point. Mm. So we think we got a critical the outcome. Mm.
Mm. Okay. Yes. Thank you. Okay. I want to put it up here. So, okay. Let's recall. You are discussing about healthcare, right? And then you are trying to come up with a good idea for your startup, right? And then you had no clue, right? And you just chose one topic for brainstorming, and here you are. You already found several interesting topics to dig into, okay? So this is what you need to do. This is what you need to do. Just one iteration, but you can still find some interesting topic about the healthcare, which you had no idea to begin with about a couple hours ago, right? So this is how you progress your solution space exploring type project, okay? I know many of you have done problem solving type project, okay? You are giving an issue, you are giving a problem, fix this, I want to go there, okay? Those are giving, but now it's not giving. If you're an entrepreneur, those problems and purposes and targets are not giving. You need to think. You need to come up with one by yourself. That's an entrepreneurship type approach, and then this is a problem solving or problem space exploration type project. So I think you guys done great job. Now you know what to think further, or what to Google, or what to do research on. All right, good. Thank you very much. All right, any other teams? I can. Yeah, okay, I'm open for any successful discussion and unsuccessful discussion as well, so that people can learn from each other. All right, wanna go?
Our team's theme was, what do you care to keep you health? And I'll explain about a very specific area, which was very interesting. This area we named serious person, and it includes like don't drink too much, sleep earlier, and eat much vegetables, know about disease, wake up early. Mm.
Like and who does this?
Serious.
Yeah. Oh, you do? Okay.
Yeah. Actually, yeah.
Four of us didn't, but he did.
Okay.
Yes, I did. Yeah.
So we asked him why. Why do you do it?
Mm.
And then he said that his baby was born.
Mm. Yes.
Year.
Yes. Actually, yeah. I got a baby this January, and I started my job from this April. Mm. Maybe it
makes me a serious person.
Ah.
Yeah. And we got an insight that maybe responsibility makes people a serious person for their healthcare.
Mm. Yeah.
This is our insight.
I see.
It's difficult by yourself. Mm. Or if it's just for yourself, it's difficult. I mean, I don't think I am this person.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay, you needed some kind of external pressure
yeah.
to force you into this form of lifestyle. Okay, good. This is it's another good example of you started out from brainstorming, you know, one topic, and you found that great interview target, and you started digging into his personal experience and why is he doing this and what's the logic behind this, right? So you found another way to dig in. So now you have this really interesting topic of, hey, responsibility, like social responsibility or family responsibility, may have great influence on this healthcare matter or the awareness of the healthcare, which is very different from what they discussed, but still quite interesting. All right, thank you very much. know there are more that you want to talk about, but let's keep it here, all right? But sorry, yes. So do you
see what we're doing here? Do you see? It's just brainstorming and then making an affinity diagram. And I know many of you have done this million times, right? But you were doing with a very low resolution or very shallow way, okay? You want to focus on some things. So it's focusing, you're focusing on thinking innovatively. You are more focusing on divergent thinking and convergent thinking. And you're more focusing on insight instead of ideas, okay? See how that changes how you behave in this kind of activities? So we're just doing brainstorming and infinity diagram, but it's still the same. It's always the same. It stays the same even though you're just discussing, okay? It stays the same even though you're having a conversation. When you are at a project like this, where you are on the project like this, the solution space exploration type project, not a problem solving project, okay? So this is the mindset. And also some techniques, and then this is how you behave, all right? So after this experience, I want you to try to read this, okay? Now I think you will find it more interesting. Now I think you understand better, okay? Because without this experience and without this basic understanding, this is just a bunch of tools. Okay, bunch of tools that means very, very less to you. Okay, very, very little to you. But with some important aspect, divergent thinking, convergent thinking, and focusing on insight, and then taking the advantage of the diversity, I think now this will communicate better to you. Okay, so that was the intention for this small session of doing brainstorming and affinity diagram. And so for maybe to put it in Japanese, when you are doing affinity diagram, you are looking for, you're actually looking for something behind the group の裏側裏側にある話とか、このグループの隙間の中に落っこちてる話とか、そういうのにもですね、こう目を向けたいわけですよね。目を向けたいわけです。なので、さらっとやっちゃえば終わります。新技なんか何枚書いても一緒だろうと絶対思ってたと思うんです。でもこう発散するときはしっかり発散してレゾリューションを上げて、要するに解像度を上げて議論するところは解像度を上げて、で皆さんですね、もっと書いた方がいいですよ。さっきあのチームがそうだったんですけど、あなんかそれってさなんとかだよね、あそうだよねとか書いた方がいいですよっていう、これですねもう3秒後に忘れてます。自分たちが何でしたっけ、さっき言ったの、ある種の緊張感があった方がいいんだよねっていう、ああそうだよねってみんなのわーとか言ってるのにうーんってこう突っ立ってるんですよ。絶対書いた方がいいです。3秒後に忘れてます。でそのある種の緊張感っていうのが皆さんの最後のヘルスケアのソリューションの実はものすごい大事なキーになるかもしれないですよね。かもしれないっていうことをですっていう緊張感を持ってやってくださいね。はい、ということなので、あのすごく単純なブレインストーミングと新話図だけをやってるんですけど、実はこれにすごくたくさんのことが含まれてます。普段のディスカッションの中でもこう海空間を探索するっていうことがどういうことなのかっていうのをですね、皆さん体感してもらいたくて、わざわざこれにこんだけ時間をかけてます。あとはですね、あの他の方法が知りたければ、もちろんこれもそうですし、いろんなあのアイディアの作り方とかなんとかとかありますし、インサイトの拾い方も書いてあります。それからこの本もすごくいいです。101デザインメソッドって言ってイリノイ工科大学の先生が作られた本ですけど、これもたくさんのデザインメソッドが書いてあります。これもですね、ただ読んだら何の意味もないです。でも今日の体験を通じてみると、ああなるほど、これやったら結構こういうインサイトとかああいうインサイトも得られそうだなとか、これがあるとすごくこう広がってきそうだなみたいな感覚で持って見れると思います。多分私たちがこれを一個一個やらなくても、皆さんはかなりのスピードでこれを学習することができるだろうと思います。 So we only covered thisbrainstorming and then affinity diagram, but this is the basics. This is the basics of diverging or ideation and then converging. Okay, so now you can go back to bootcamp bootleg or even this design 101 design method. This is comprehended by Institute of Illinois Institute of Technology. Yes, Illinois Institute of Technology professor. Now you can learn different methodologies and tools, and you know how to use them, okay? And don't let the tools use you, okay? You need to use the tools, all right? So that's what we wanted to do through this exercise. All right, well, I know you're tired. Aren't your leg tired? 足だるくないですか？そうなります。あと頭もすごいだるくないですか？こうなります。おやつ食べてくださいね。Okay, let's take another 10-minute break. Let's be back at 20 after 4, okay? All right.
Okay, welcome back. I know it's a long day.
It's already 4:20, but we have a little bit more to go, all right? Because we only have 3 days. Like I said, I announced you, I informed you, this is going to be intensive, short course work, right? Like I said, it will be. So, all right. So we have done brainstorming as one form of free association major. And this is in Japanese, is 自由連想法. Okay, in contrast, we have forced association major, which is 強制連想法. 強制連想法. And we're going to talk about this now. So, forced association is it means different variation of ideas are generated using a set of conditions or rules, okay? So when we did free association, we had no conditions or rules, right? You can just build on others' ideas, right? But now you have a set of conditions or rules, and you want to choose the conditions or rules so you can explore the solution space further. That's the whole point. And it may be effective for those who are not yet familiar with free association major, such as brainstorming. So I think this is very typical for people who works for a Japanese company. It's very difficult to conduct brainstorming with your colleagues, isn't it? Yes? Because they are not willing to 連想. They're not willing to go for crazy ideas. This is always the case. Maybe it's only true in certain areas, but I have seen in a lot. We have been working with many companies and many organizations with such project work or training, and then we have seen this a lot. In that case, 自由連想法 or brainstorming does not work, 強制連想法, free association major might work better sometimes because there are some conditions or rules that you can follow. So this may sometimes work, okay? Before we get into the method, I want to show you a good example of free association major and its outcome. Who knows this? Oh, I forgot to bring this. I had this upstairs. Shoot. Who knows this? Who has no idea what this is? Okay, I will show you. So I will show you a very exciting movie of this product. So you better watch out, because this is exciting. It's a really exciting movie. Don't fall asleep. So now, do you know what this is? This is called Mugen Puchi Puchi, infinite bubble wrap. Okay? This infinite bubble, this was a great hit toy. I don't know when, 2008, 7? But yeah, sometime in the past. It was a great hit. Okay? This idea was generated using forced association major. Okay? I'll show you the TED. Thank you. ハートが強いですよね。あのジョークをあそこで言えるっていうのはちょっと僕にはできないなっていつも思うんですけど。So, okay. So it was a TED by this Takahashi-san, who is at Bandai. So Bandai is a company produces toys for kids. And then, so it was a forced association of a toy and then the random shiritori. So it was a, word chain game, okay? Word chain game. So bubble wrap associated with a toy idea, okay? And then forced random association generated an out-of-the-box idea, that just like he said. And association randomness was introduced by word chain game. So it means you should have some kind of randomness when you associate. Because if you associate the normal things to normal things, what do you get? You get boring idea, right? Like dolls and girls, like doll and girl, then you get the Barbie doll. That's makes not much sense. But if you get like ojisan and doll and ojisan doll, then that's somewhat different, right? So you want to randomize your how you associate two different items or three different items or whatsoever. So for him, it was the word chain game that triggered or that introduced the randomness into his association. So, oh, here's the Japanese version. そうですね。ランダム性をうまく意図的に強制連想に持たせるってところが、まあ、ポイントかなということですね。はい。So there are so many ways to force associate ideas and force associate ideas and then generate new one. I'm going to show you, we're going to do just one type of forced association. There are so many of them, but this is the basic and classic. This is a very simple and easy to use methodology. You can go through the book that I showed you, Design Method. They have some forced association measures, and maybe the Bootcamp Bootleg did not clearly state it that there's forced association measures, but there are some similar ones, like analogous empathy. I think they are somewhat some form of forced association. So I'm going to introduce you to the forced association matrix. So it's a kind of forced association measure. It's a forced associate two items to generate items on a matrix format. So that's what it is. It is to explore the solution space, of course. And then you want to remind yourself that you are not looking for the greatest idea to appear on the matrix, but you are exploring more options and looking for insight. Okay, again, it's the same thing. So still stay on brainstorming mode, okay? So welcome wild, crazy ideas and give every post-it note a short positive feedback. And this is how it looks like. So you have ideation question, again, same, because it's still the ideation, one part of the or one style of ideation. How might we question or whatever question you have for ideation. And then you prepare a blank matrix like this. Row items 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Column items 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. It could be anything, okay? And you generate ideas in here. How you do it is you multiply row item 1 and column item 1 and try to answer this question using these two triggers or cues, okay? So in Japanese, it's the best explanation is ogiri, okay? Or muchaburi, okay? It's basically, technically, muchaburi. There is no answer to these matrix, but you are forced to think, all right? So you can put it on a post-it note and then come up with new ideas like this. So example is like, how might we communicate face-to-face without a common language? And you can maybe have like body parts, device, and sound, and you can have like, you know, the size of the group, like within a family, among friends, neighborhood. You can have such entries here, and then you go, okay, using body parts and within family, what could be an idea? Okay? and then you try to answer this question. How might we communicate face-to-face without a common language? Let's see. All right? So it's hard. It's probably harder to come up with this idea than brainstorming, because now you are forced and you have certain conditions to meet, right? But it's okay. It's fun. So, all right? So let's try. Let's try this. Okay. Now you, of course, need to start from here. Discuss and create matrix. Decide the ideation question, and then items in rows, items in columns. All right? So first you create this blank matrix with some items in rows, some items in columns. All right? And then, of course, you need to have a question. You can have the same question as you did in the brainstorming. This is another style of ideation. This may give you different type of ideas. So you can try that as well if you want to. And then conduct forced association on the matrix. And how do you introduce the randomness to the matrix? This is important, okay? You can do shiritori, word chain, or you can just Google some buzzword, okay? Just go on Yahoo headline and then just pick random words, okay? Just, you need to have some kind of randomness. Otherwise, your brain will choose decent words. And it makes no sense. It makes no sense because you want to force associate your brain to go outside of the box and think in a weird, uncomfortable area. Okay, you want to bring your brain to that area. And then what can you do to find innovative perspective or insight? So how can you set your matrix so that you may be able to find innovative perspective or innovative insight? Okay, and you're forcing unusual discussion to generate unusual ideas. All right, this is important. You need to force yourself to do unusual discussion. Basically, it's muchaburi. All right, there is no answer. So you cannot be too logical to come up with an answer. All right, good. All right, so let's prepare the new sheet of paper and then discuss the question and discuss the matrix. Prepare the matrix and you can start the ideation. All right. And like I said, it may be a little bit difficult, but keep trying. I'll give you 30 minutes. So try, create a matrix, and start ideating with force association major. Okay, you can start. Oh yes, you are still on the topic of the healthcare, so you can start ideating based on your affinity diagram discussion or whatever.
あ、これ、ちょっと、まあ、ちょっと、ちょっと、ちょっと、ちょっと、ちょっと、ちょっと、ちょっと、ちょっと、ちょっと、ちょっと、ちょっと、ちょっと、ちょっと、ちょっと、ちょっと、ちょっと、ちょっと、ちょっと、ちょっと、ちょっと、ちょっと、ちょっと、ちょっと、ちょっと、ちょっと、ちょっと、ちょっと、ちょっと、ちょっと、ちょっと、ちょっと、ちょっと、ちょっと、ちょっと、ちょっと、ちょっと、ちょっと、ちょっと、ちょっと、ちょっと、ちょっと、ちょっと、ちょっと、ちょっと、ちょっと、ちょっと、ちょっと、ちょっと、ちょっと、ちょっと、ちょっと、ちょっと、ちょっと、ちょっと、ちょっと、ちょっと、ちょっと、ちょっと、ちょっと、ちょっと、ち あの、なんか、あの、なんか、あの、なんか、あの、なんか、あの、なんか、あの、なんか、あの、なんか、あの、なんか、あの、なんか、あの、なんか、あの、なんか、あの、なんか、あの、なんか、あの、なんか、あの、なんか、あの、なんか、あの、なんか、あの、なんか、あの、なんか、あの、なんか、あの、なんか、あの、なんか、あの、なんか、あの、なんか、あの、なんか、あの、なんか、あの、なんか、あの、なんか、あの、なんか、あの、なんか、あの、なんか、あの、なんか、あの、なんか、あの、なんか、あの、なんか、あの、なんか、あの、なんか、あの、なんか、あの、なんか、あの、なんか、あの、なんか、あの、なんか、あの、なんか、あの、なんか、あの、なんか、あの、なんか、あの、なんか、あの、なんか、あの、なんか、あの、なんか、あの、なんか、あの、なんか、あの、なんか、あの、なんか、 Thank you. まあ、あんまり。 違う。なんだ。海。
So let's change the gear and then try to find insight. So some ideas may have interesting point of view hints. Okay, some ideas have very new point of view. Crazy looking idea may trigger innovative insight. And controversial idea may have a hint to break the bias that you have. And you reinterpret the post-it notes to look for insight. That's what you're doing. Okay, unusual ideas may give you new and valuable insight. So that's the mindset, mentality that you want to put on right now, and then try to look at your crazy ideas. Okay? Oh, I'm sorry, innovative ideas. All right, now let's search for the insight. I'll give you another 15 minutes or so. So take your insight noted, post-it note, and then don't forget, don't just speak, okay? You need to write it down. Okay, because it's going to slip from your mind right away unless you write it down. Okay, now go on.
ゆとりが欲しいときと、やっぱりある種の緊張感が欲しいので、緊張感が欲しいので、緊張感が欲しいので、緊張感が欲しいので、緊張感が欲しいので、緊張感が欲しいので、緊張感が欲しいので、緊張感が欲しいので、緊張感が欲しいので、緊張感が欲しいので、緊張感が欲しいので、緊張感が欲しいので、緊張感が欲しいので、緊張感が欲しいので、緊張感が欲しいので、緊張感が欲しいので、緊張感が欲しいので、緊張感が欲しいので、緊張感が欲しいので、緊張感が欲しいので、緊張感が欲しいので、緊張感が欲しいので、緊張感が欲しいので、緊張感が欲しいので、緊張感が欲しいので、緊張感が欲しいので、緊張感が欲しいので、緊張感が欲しいので、緊張感が欲しいので、緊張感が欲しいので、緊張感が欲しいので、緊張感が欲しいので、緊張感が Thank you. Gracias.
Interesting insight. So you need to remind yourself that you are still thinking about healthcare and you're trying to come up with creative or innovative idea to develop your concept, right? So you're still in that phase. Pretend you are that team. So let's hear from the teams that have not spoken recently. Any insights? Yes. Tell us about your insights.
We are thinking about the moment when we feel like healthy and unpleasant. Mm. And this line is an insight from the previous work affinity diagram.
Okay, and so you yeah. use the result yeah. of the affinity yeah. diagram to yeah. make a Foster association matrix, okay?
And this line is random factors.
Okay.
And so
random factors, okay. Yeah. You just randomly chose some yeah. factors, okay?
Like shofukute tsurube, wakwak-san.
Well, that's random.
True. And we focused on these two lines because there are many ideas was generated.
Okay.
And this is Yutori, and this is consciousness of like so kinchoka stress. Mm-hmm. So so maybe so we our insight is to both we need for feeling healthy or present. So to make to provide people with stressful situation mm-hmm. or pressure and non-stress or more free feeling.
Mm-hmm.
So to combine these two is mm. very important in thinking about healthcare. This is our insight. For example, when we when we go to gym, mm-hmm. after that we take a bath or maybe there is a gym equipped with spring.
Okay.
So this is so maybe we can think new innovative healthcare system using these insights.
Okay. So what would you say your next move will be? What your team might do?
So picking these insights and to see the like other things related with healthcare
mm.
to utilize these insights.
Okay. So maybe one thing you may be able to do is go on a Google and say there's a stress and then there's a stress relief combined together for you know some kind of healthcare. Maybe you can type in these keywords and try to find if there are any related topic to your idea. Or you can go ask expert, yeah. like you know expert in I don't know physiology or whatever, to ask him opinion. Take you know to ask him his opinion or her opinion. Okay.
We came up with a story.
Mm-hmm. That so as he said, we put the show tsurube, the chair, the comedian.
Yes.
And also, we mm-hmm. put the chair.
Okay.
And so we combined the story. That
you know, to see the funny things, we life is you know better, mm-hmm. make a better place. But to mix with the chair, let's say if the chair is unstable,
mm.
and looking at the funny thing with the chair unstable,
mm.
will you know, will create the body is so strong,
mm-hmm.
so we can combine with those two things.
Ah, okay, you may say that's a crazy idea, but do you know the shoes that's unbalanced? I think Reebok, is it a Reebok shoes? Yes, Reebok shoe that has a tilted the sole, it's not flat, you need to actually balance it, and it is for healthcare. So, okay, I think you got the insight, you're similar insight what they got, probably. All right, good, thank you. So, as you see, this is another approach of generating ideas, idea generation. So you can choose. You can choose either doing free association or forced association. And you may have some different insights, okay? It's not about choosing one or the other, but it's a combination of these two things. And how did you choose this random things on your rows?
Things which we can see now, like
ah, okay, stuff like we this. Have in this room.
Yeah.
Ah, okay, good. All right. Sometimes you just walk, go for a walk for like 5 minutes and just write down whatever you saw, like door, lights. You can do that too. So you want to get some crazy randomness into your idea generation. All right, thank you. Any one more team? All right.
Okay, there are many crazy ideas, but I will introduce one of them, one insight. Our topic is how can we make healthy, how can we make healthy for the single student, especially in the viewpoint of the food. So we think about single.
Oh, okay. Living alone, right? Oh,
yes, yes.
Being single and living alone is different
living
things.
Living alone. Sorry. So we think about the situation for the research student. Only every day he researches day and night. So I think they want they always had the convenience stores some cheap bento. So it is not healthy, but they don't have enough time to cook and go restaurant. So we think about the idea. So rental okan, which means the some woman cooked and deliver to the laboratory and give the give dinner or lunch. And from this idea, we got an insight that we only think about the food, but these kinds of people feel not only the food problem, but also they want to feel some anshinkan, I think. So next, our next step is to, what is the other factor to get some food in health, in healthy? For example, like we want to feel anshinkan, natsukashita.
Okay.
That's it?
Sure, yeah.
I always do that. The funny thing is that we found that rental okan would be really interesting for us, and then we thought, like, oh, why we think it's interesting. And the funny thing is that, like, we didn't think much about the previous one.
Okay, the free association.
So after that, like, we found that previously we talked about food might be similar to fashion because some people do it really well, but it is only somebody see it.
Somebody do it
really well, but it is for somebody to show or it is to show somebody or something like that.
You and pretend you are eating healthy when somebody's looking
somebody
at you.
We found that like somebody might need it to be healthy in order to have a good food. That might be kind of insight. And then, okay, lentil okan would be interesting. And for example, for some girl who just separate with her boyfriend, they might need some lentil obosan or something like that. I mean, we need somebody to spend time with for somebody to have healthy food with. Not only one person cannot be enough to have healthy food. That would be kind of just an idea, but we thought something like that.
Right. Okay. Yeah. I think that could be a great insight. So you've been talking about healthcare, and then you've been talking about individual, but maybe it's similar to the discussion that what they had. You need some kind of responsibility or somebody to, you know, look after you, or you need to look after somebody. Then you become responsible to take good care of your health. And then so you had that insight as well. So you probably need a partner or somebody to maybe do it with, or maybe, I don't know, being observed by, or I don't know, being monitored by. But you brought somebody into this picture, and you can generate some new ideas.
Yeah, that's true. And another question would be, what if Obento says, like otsukaresama or something, not only person but obento, something like that.
Okay.
Like, the idea generates a lot.
Okay. So you started from thinking about one person or individual, but now you brought one more person or one more personality into this picture, and then you're seeing how dynamics changes. Good. All right. Thank you very much. So, see what happened? You started off from scratch, right? You started off from the white piece of whiteboard paper, and you had nothing on the whiteboard. And then you just, what you did is just you brainstormed, you made a affinity diagram, and what you did is another ideation. That's all. That's all you did. But do you feel the intensity of the discussion you've done? I think it's very different from what you have done before, right? because of the some keywords that we've been discussing. So you're focusing. I think the biggest keyword that I think it's really important is the insight. You want to look for the insight. You're not looking for, of course, at the end you want the solution or the idea, but you are looking for insight to be able to build a solution in the near future or your next step. So I think this really helps you to broaden your thoughts and then, you know, become more sensitive about what's interesting and what's innovative, what could be innovative, okay? So that's a sense that I really want you to keep throughout this course, okay?